Mr. Tarrou, in this calculus lesson, we are going to do a two-part example where we find the slope of this polar curve at a particular point and then find the tangent line, the equation of the tangent line at that point for this curve. I'll finish up the video by doing a little screen capture video using a T-Inspire where I graph this polar curve and then I put the tangent line along with that graph so you can see how they interact and how, you know, basically validate the answer that we get. So we have here the slope in polar form. If f is a differentiable function of theta, then the slope of the tangent line to the graph r is equal to f of theta, so it's going to be basically r in terms of theta somehow, at the point r theta, well, that slope, that derivative, is dy dx is equal to or found by doing the derivative of y with respect to theta, and that's going to be f of theta times cosine theta plus f prime of theta times sine of theta over dx d theta, which the denominator says here, negative f theta times sine theta plus f prime theta cosine theta. Now, really, it's not going to seem like I'm following this formula here because we're just going to follow this tip. To find the slope in a polar graph, you first need to write that, this polar equation in parametric form. That's how we're taking the derivative of y with respect to theta and the derivative of x with respect to theta, how we have those two parts. Now what you see in the numerator and denominator here is basically just what we have here as y is equal to r times sine theta. And we might think of r as a constant, but here it's saying r is equal to f of theta. So you're basically looking at the product, the derivative rule, the product rule for derivatives, excuse me, which is the first. Now remember that r is basically going to be like a f of theta sine. And we're looking at the first times the derivative of the second plus the second times the derivative of the first. So as you look at this kind of complicated looking formula for the slope in polar form, it's really just the product rule for r cosine theta and r or f of theta sine theta in the numerator and denominator. I'm not going to point to this as we go through our problems, we're just going to take this tip. To find the slope in a polar graph, first write it as parametric equations using these two equations. So we have our first example, really our only example as far as the equation goes. We're going to find the slope at 4 pi over 6, and in the second part of this example we're going to find the equation of that tangent line in rectangular form. Well, we need an equation for x. Well, x is equal to r times cosine theta, and our equation is equal to r, so we're going to replace, for that x equation, we're going to replace r with x over cosine theta. Okay, so we have x over cosine theta is equal to 2 plus 4 sine theta. And now we need that equation for y, so again, we're just going to take r out, but this time replace it with y over sine. And that gives us, taking the r out, y over the sine of theta is equal to 2 plus 4 sine theta. Distributing the cosine for x, we have 2 cosine theta plus 4 sine theta cosine theta. And for y, multiplying both sides of this equation by sine, we have y, I'm going to try it a little bit smaller here, 2 sine theta plus 4 sine squared theta. Now we're just going to find the derivative with respect to theta of x and y. So we have dx d theta. The derivative of cosine, of course, is negative sine, so we have negative 2 sine theta. Ooh, now, I can use the product rule here to do the derivative of 4 times sine theta cosine theta, or we can remember that 2 sine theta cosine theta times 2. So our 2 times 2 is that coefficient of 4 that I just erased. And this is your double angle identity for sine. 2 sine cosine, or 2 sine theta cosine theta, is equal to the sine of 2 theta. Now, my notes actually showed all those steps, but I want to leave this first part of the notes up as we find these derivatives. So now we're looking at the derivative of sine is cosine. So we have plus 2 cosine of 2 theta, and finishing that chain rule, of course, because that 2 theta is inside the sine function. The derivative of 2 theta with respect to theta is just simply 2. So we have dx theta is equal to negative 2 sine theta plus 4 cosine of 2 theta. Coming over here to our equation that describes the vertical motion of our polar graph, or polar curve, and finding dy d theta. Well, the derivative of sine is cosine. So we have 2 cosine theta, and 2 times 4 is 8. Oh, I'm going to run out of room. Bring that exponent down by 1, and the derivative. And now we have to finish the chain rule, because the sine function, of course, is in that power of 2, and the derivative of sine is cosine. Very sorry for squeezing this together here. Okay, so we have, now I'm going to write out our dy d theta, or dy dx, I mean. For dy d theta in the numerator, we have 2 cosine theta plus 8 sine theta cosine theta all over negative 2 sine theta plus 4 cosine of 2 theta. Now, if we wanted to simplify this a little bit, again, we have that sine cosine. So I could write this as 4 times 2 sine theta cosine theta and write that as a double angle identity as well, but we're just trying to find the slope of this curve at the point 4 pi over 6. Well, of course, that's r theta, and our derivative is in terms of theta. So we're not going to use the r value 4 in our calculation of our slope. We're just going to use theta is equal to pi over 6. Well, yeah, so I'm taking all these thetas out, plugging in pi over 6. We have 2 cosine of pi over 6 plus 8 times the sine of pi over 6 cosine of pi over 6. In the denominator, we have negative 2 sine of pi over 6 plus 4 cosine, and now that 2 times pi over 6, of course, is going to be basically the cosine of pi over 3. I'm just going to plug all these values in, or I've got the theta of pi over 6 plugged in, but I'm going to pull these values out of the unit circle, do a little bit of simplification, and that will be the slope of r is equal to 2 plus 4 sine of theta at the point 4 pi over 6. Now, as you're thinking about these problems, be careful that you don't just think, oh, well, the derivative of 2 plus 4 sine of theta is going to be, what, 4 cosine of theta, because the derivative of sine is cosine. If you just take the derivative of 2 plus 4 sine theta with respect to theta, well, that's going to be dr d theta. That's going to be the rate of change, if you will, for the radius. Okay, no, we're looking for the slope, a change in y over a change in x, you know, at a particular point. So we are looking at a dy dx value of 3, square root of 3. Now, how do we use that slope at the point of tangency of 4 pi over 6 to write the equation of a tangent line? Because while I have a point, that's an r theta, you know, it's in polar form. And equations of lines are simpler if you see them in rectangular form. So we're going to write this equation of the tangent line in the point slope form, y minus y sub 1 equals m times x minus x sub 1 right now. Alrighty, so we have our board cleared off, and now let's find the x and y coordinates for this point. Now, we already have taken our polar equation out of polar form and into parametric. And the equation that describes the x-coordinate, again, only uses theta, and, well, actually, so does the polar form, and our y is in terms of theta as well. So we have our x-coordinate is equal to 2 cosine of theta, which is pi over 6, plus 2 sine theta. We got 2 cosine of pi over 6 is square root of 3 over 2. Sine, of course, is 1 half. And we're looking at square root of 3 plus 1, our x coordinate. Let me just double check that. Yeah. It is helpful if you use the right equation. Okay, that's why I check my notes. Let's try that again. It's 2 right here. 2 times pi over 6. So we've got 2 square root of 3 over 2 plus 2. And the sine of pi over 3 is again square root of 3 over 2. This is looking like I remember my notes saying. Square root of 3 plus square root of 3 is 2 square root of 3. Now let's get to that y coordinate. 2 sine theta plus 4 sine squared theta. 2 times the sine of, I'm just going to skip that part, writing it out. 2 times theta is pi over 6. So 2 times the sine of pi over 6, the sine of pi over 6 is 1 half. Plus 4 times the sine, again, of pi over 6 squared, sine of pi over 6, 1 half. So we're looking at 1 plus 1 half squared is 1 fourth. 4 times 1 fourth is 1. And we get 2. So the equation of our tangent line is y minus y sub 1, y minus 2 equals m, 3 squared of 3, times x minus x sub 2. And just to let you see what I'm doing for getting this prepared to put it into the calculator, we've got 3 square root of 3x. We've got square root of 3 times square root of 3 is 3. We got 3 times 2 is 6. So 6 times 3 is 18, right? 3 times 6 is 18. Add 2 to both sides, and we get y is equal to 3 square root of 3x minus 16. Just double check since I already made some silly little mistake. Now let's get this graphed and see how this tangent line, make sure, right, that this actually is a tangent line. See how this tangent line is related to our polar graph. R is equal to 2 plus 4 sine of theta. No. Okay, so here we have our calculator pulled up with a graphing window. I'm going to hit menu, select graph, edit entry, and choose our polar option. And we're going to type in 2 plus 4 cosine, nope, that was sine of theta. And here we go. We have our graph up here. Now what are we going to do to type in our tangent line in rectangular form, excuse me. So we're going to hit tab and go down to another line. Actually, it's already a second line.
Now, I'm going to hit menu, graph entry, and go back to a function. And that's going to let me type in a rectangular function and leave the graph of my polar function here. So we're going to type in 3 square root of 3. Come out of that radical. X minus 16. And voila, we see that tangent line up here interacting with our graph or going through the tangent point of tangency of 4, pi over 6. Now, let's see, I'm pretty sure since these are different on different coordinate planes or coordinate systems that if I hit menu and analyze graph and look for an intersection that it's going to allow me to choose graph 1, but the second graph is not going to let us select that polar curve. So looking at this point of tangency and just kind of verifying maybe the validity of your answer, besides of course just checking the back of the book, you can hit window and zoom in. No, I don't want to change the center. There we go. Go ahead and zoom in on that. And you can hit menu, trace the graph, and you can come through here and see that we have around 4.09, which is almost 4, and 0.55 radians. And of course, if you take pi and divide it by 6, you get something around that point. And you can play around with the the values of your tracing, but we do have our tangent line to our polar curve.
So now you know how to find the equation of a tangent line to a polar curve, in this case, a lemmasome. I'm Mr. True. Bam! Go do your homework.